हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू टी कप टैरो। हाउ आर यू गाइस? आई होप यू गाइस आर डूइंग वेल। एंड हाउ हैज़ द मंथ ऑफ मे बीन लाइक फॉर यू? बिकॉज वी आर रियली कमिंग टूवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ मे एंड जून इज जस्ट नॉकिंग ऑन आर डोर। सो एज वी मूव फॉरवर्ड, आई वॉन्टेड टू सी वॉट द मंथ ऑफ जून इज गोइंग टू बी लाइक एनर्जी वाइज एंड ऑफकोर्स वॉट अपॉर्चुनिटीज आर गोइंग बी कमिंग योर वे, वॉट ब्लेसिंग्स आर कमिंग योर वे, वॉट चेंजेस आर कमिंग your way. So having said that, I have three piles here laid out in front of me. So please pick one that really speaks to you the most and then we'll start with pile one. Hello, and if you've picked pile one, then this is what you can expect for the month of June. So as always, I'll lay out all the cards. So what was the most fun thing that you did in the month of May? Let me know if you had something that you did. And what are your plans for the month of June? Do you have any resolutions? Do you have any holiday plans? Let me know in the comment section down below. You know how much I love reading your comments. So, all right. Basically, let me tell you pile one. First of all, the month of June looks really, really good to me, all right? Because what is happening is you're really, really driven. You're feeling good about yourself. You're feeling very, very ambitious. And also there is this satisfaction of having done something well. So having accomplished a great deal in the month of May and in the months before that, you are moving forward boldly and strongly. Along with that, there is also a sense of movement, like a physical movement. So maybe you may go on a little trip, you may go on a holiday, or you may just travel for something like travel related to work, travel related to pleasure. That is on the cards for you. But also for a couple of you, for people who wanting to get that new vehicle, the energy of the new vehicle is coming in. So maybe you will get the delivery of your car if you've booked it already, or maybe book a car that is also showing up. But financially, this is going to be a very, very good month for you. Okay, you'll be feeling really good about yourself. You are fulfilled, like all of your needs are going to be taken care of, and you'll also have that extra amount of money to spend. And spending is very much highlighted for you, because that little bit of extra expense, because you have that extra bit of money, is really showing up. But along with that, there is also a sense of I have done a job well, I've accomplished so much, there is already so much that I've done, and now I'm just going to rest a bit. Okay, so you are not really feeling very much inclined to make a lot of changes to your work situation. You're not feeling like making too many changes to your home situation. Okay, you're just playing it safe. You're resting is what I'm getting here. Again, especially when your money is concerned, I believe this month you are going to be making a lot of decisions. Okay, decisions relating to investments are also showing up here. But either way, money is really playing on very strongly in your mind, and especially with this card showing up, assessing situation. So this month you're already looking at options. Okay, I have this option, I have that option, this possibility exists and that possibility exists, but I don't really see you making any firm decisions this month. Okay, that is also showing very strongly. Because along with that assessing card, you also have the card of Seven of Cups. So a lot of choices may show up in front of you, especially career wise is also possible. Maybe in terms of the job market, you will see, like, according to your potential, there are a lot of things that you can do, and you're just looking at them, okay, like assessing them one at a time, but not really making any decision. And honestly, I'm not going to be telling you that it is important for you to make those decisions, because what I see is you're playing by your strengths. You know your strengths, you know your weaknesses, and you are just comfortable being where you are. All right, that is showing up. But again, there is this element of confidence for you. You know what you are, you know what you want, and you're willing to take your time to make certain changes is also coming up. But let me warn you slightly a little bit here. Maybe the reason why you're not able to make these decisions is because you're slightly looking at things and situations in a negative frame of mind, all right? Especially maybe because of the COVID situation showing up, or maybe you just feel like you're not in the right frame of mind. You're just looking at things slightly negatively. So I am here to encourage you, look at things with a sense of possibility, look at things with a sense of hope, and just put that one foot forward instead of just assessing your situations, all right? Let me tell you, this is a good time to release negativity, especially if you are watching this video around the lunar eclipse time and the eclipse has not already started. Maybe do a ritual for yourself where you release the negativity, because as you release the negativity, you will feel like you're more confident and you're willing to really take those risks that otherwise you are not able to take. But let me tell you something, this month there is also a possibility of little bit of challenges in your relationship situations, okay? This doesn't always have to be your romantic relationship. This can just be relationship, like with your friends, with your family, again, you know, with the Mercury situation going on. So please ensure that whatever you're communicating this month is very clear communication. It shouldn't really happen that you are trying to say something and the other person is misunderstanding you. So the possibility of misunderstanding does show up in your reading. So ensure that your communication is very clear, all right? But either way, physically, in terms of your health, I do see you getting really strong. So if you have any health issues, you are going to be healing from them, and in fact your health is going to be returning. In certain cases, because of this card showing up, which basically talks about physical activity, so maybe this month for you, you may actually take up an exercise routine, you may take up a new diet routine. If you want to start going to the gym, start a new routine, I suggest you do that. But do something this month relating to your physique, okay? Do something that will help you build up your energy levels. Do something that will help you build up your strength, because that strength building is something that is going to be very, very essential for you if you want that good health. But either way, please ensure you're eating a lot of greens. Exposure to sunlight is again very, very important to you. And again, let me remind you, please let go of negativity, because again, you know, if you have negativity, if you're looking at things in a slightly not so positive manner, that affects your health and aura as well. Yeah, but either way, when it comes to your relationships, I see forward movement in your relationships, okay? So there is progress where there wasn't any progress. Like possibly you may decide to start dating again, you may decide it's time to change your dating patterns. That is also coming, because in spite of the fact that you were so much in your comfort zone, you are willing to move forward, okay? But again, let me tell you, you're also in a very, very good place mentally. You're in a good place emotionally, and that will show up in your relationships as well. But again, let me tell you, there are a lot of decisions that you may have to take when it comes to your romantic life as well. So sitting down, discussing things with your partner about money, about your relationship is very much on the card. And in certain cases, this can actually be, you know, sitting down to discuss about where your relationship is and what needs to be out of the relationship and what needs to be replaced as a result of this new energy, all right? Because they release the negativity. Again, please pay attention to your communication patterns this month. That is what is coming up for you. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you an extra card, like I did in my weekly reading as well, because I do believe you guys enjoy it firstly, and it just helps us wrap up the entire reading. All right. Optimism. After each rainstorm, there will be clear skies. All right. So basically, you are being asked to be more optimistic. All right. So again, it's time to release negativity. So maybe, you know, especially because you recently had a full moon energy, you had an eclipse. If you manage to release your negativity, if you get rid of that entirely and look at things in an optimistic point of view, I see that forward movement happening very strongly. So be optimistic. Any decisions that you have to take, make sure you're taking it only because you're feeling really, really good about it. And you have a little bird spirit showing up for you, supporting you and probably encouraging you to be more optimistic. You have number 30 from your numbers. So these are important numbers which can actually be important dates for you. You have 16, 19, 30, 23 and 26. From your letters, you have G, I, S, G again. Let me know if you find your full names or even your initials. I know a lot of people do. So, yeah. I prefer having the bird energies around, you know, because I am one person, I always connect with the energies of nature. So I just let them be a part of my reading. Let me know if that annoys you, because I know sometimes, you know, some people don't really like it. I'm sorry in which case, but either way, these are your letters for the upcoming month. Let me know what things you find out here, and I wish you the very, very best for the month of June. All my prayers and my best wishes are with you. I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Hello, and if you've selected pile 2, these are the energies of June coming through for you. So first of all, like always, I will be arranging your cards and then we'll get into the overall reading. So how was the month of May for you? Did you do something fun? Did you do something exciting? Let me know in the comment section. If you have any plans for the month of June, let me know that as well. So if we start with the reading, the very, very first thing that stands out for me is the card of the Empress. Now, the Empress brings such a beautiful energy with her. She is the energy of fulfillment. She is the energy of abundance. So I do believe the month of June is especially going to be abundant for you, but it is also going to bring you a lot of happiness, okay? So maybe a lot of happy news coming out for you. In certain cases, I also see you guys going out on a holiday, going out with friends, making a lot of dates, probably in a spa, probably just at home with your friends. Connecting with people you love is also going to be a huge thing when it comes to the month of June. Again, there is also a possibility of certain family get-togethers happening. People who you love, people who you care, just getting together just to be with each other, okay? That energy is also there. But again, the month of June also brings with it a certain kind of a change, all right? Because you have the card of the Metamorphosis. So I don't really see this as much of an external change. Of course, that can be a possibility. But as a person, you're also changing. Your choices are changing. The way you want your life to show up is also very much changing, okay? Again, your interests are very much going to be changing. Again, like I'm telling you, there might be a sense of certain kind of a discontentment that you may have faced in the month of May, and you're finally moving out of that discontentment. You're starting to feel good about yourself. You're feeling very, very positive, all right? And again, there is also a possibility of travel showing up, travel relating to work, travel relating to pleasure, again a possibility. But this month, there is also a news coming towards you, okay? This can be in the form of a letter, this can be in the form of an email, this can be in the form of a phone call. Again, the possibility of certain new friendships forming is also very much on the cards for you. Again, there is also a possibility of a promotion showing up, because you also have the Empress in the cards, or maybe the possibility of a new employment is also showing up for you, you know, especially with the Ace of Wands and the Eight really showing up. Again, for people who've been wanting to change their residence, this is a good options, especially changing your residence in an area that you're comfortable with, in an area that brings you joy and happiness, is again very much on the cards for you. But there is also a sort of an indecisive energy to you in the month of June. So maybe you are being asked to make certain decisions, certain important decisions, something like, should I go for this job? Should I not go for this job? Or something as simple as, should I add highlights to my hair or should I just let my hair be the way they are? But there are some decisions that you need to take and you're not willing to take it, okay? Because I just feel like you are like, okay, should I do this? Should I not do this? But in the end, I feel like you will make these decisions, and these decisions will really, really propel you forward. Again, there is this element of adjustment is required. So maybe the way you are operating currently needs to shift. Your mindset needs to shift, because once that mindset shifts, you know, your life will really, really change. And again, you know, you also have a separate card of abundance showing up. So money is going to be pouring in for you, all right? Maybe a possibility of a promotion is there, or maybe receiving money from an unexpected source, very much a possibility. But you're focused on abundance as well. So maybe creating abundance is something that you're thinking about. Changing your job, getting a new job, or getting a separate job, you know, like two jobs is also very much possible. But this month you are encouraged to follow your dreams, and I feel like you'll naturally do that, okay, with the Ace of Wands showing up. So beginning of a passion project, beginning of a side business, beginning of a new area of learning is also very much a possibility. But with the entire element of change showing up, this month is going to be filled with changes for you. Changes to your appearance is also showing up. Changes in your location is showing up. Changes in your job area is also showing up. But this month, let me tell you, you may want to sort of make some scheduled time for rest, because it is going to be a very action-packed month for you. So you'll be like, go, go, go. I want to do this. I want to do that. I want to figure this out. I want to figure this out. But please ensure that you're resting, that you're taking care of yourself. And meditation is something that you should be making a priority for you this month. Again, the adjustments are required can also be when it comes to your schedule. Okay, changing your schedule can also really help you this month. But for a couple of you, I also see you guys taking meditation classes. I also see you paying more attention to yoga and your spiritual life. Okay, your spiritual life again is also going to thrive very much this month. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm also going to give you an extra card like I did in my previous reading. I believe you guys enjoy that. Okay, flyer. Change. Oh, wow. So you have change coming up for you this month. So I do believe in most areas of your life, you're going to be experiencing change. And again, let me tell you, with the Saturn going into retrograde and with the Mercury changing its position as well, I believe the change is going to be something that is necessary. In certain cases, this can actually be moving away from an old life. Moving out of something that no longer fits is also a possibility. All right. So you need a new shell, and that is something you're moving forward, and moving towards your dreams is again very much a possibility. Let me give you one more just to see if anything else is highlighted. I'll take this. Perseverance. Stay to the course. Okay, so you're basically being asked that if you want to do something, especially relating to your dreams, especially relating to something new, then don't quit it as soon as you started, because there is this indecisive energy as well, and just stay the course. Okay, so if you continue doing what you're doing, then you know you will really get the results that you get. But I don't really see this as a continuance of a previous life or a previous course. This is something new that you choose for yourself, and you keep going towards it. You make adjustments wherever required, but I do believe if you keep walking towards it, you will actually reach the abundance that you're seeking. That is coming forth. I feel like the need to give you one more just to wrap things up. Listen. The secrets of the sea become apparent when we listen to the sounds within the shell. So I will tell you, basically just listen to yourself, listen to your intuition, especially when it comes to making any important decisions. Because I do believe you guys, since you're making a lot of changes, I do believe there will be slight kind of a confusion, which is really highlighted here. But if you listen to yourself, if you remain true to your dreams, you will be entirely where you are meant to be, and then stay the course. All right. So that is what is coming up for you. For your numbers, you have 33, number 1, you have 26, you have number 6, can be 9 as well. Again, if it is 9, this can actually be the completion of something and the beginning of something new. Again, 13 with the, you know, being associated with the death card, transformation, change really makes sense, but you are protected by your spirit guides. And 22 again is a very, very powerful number. So one more thing that I really get here, the changes that you're making right now, you know, you are right in the mid of 2021. So the changes that you make right now, if you stick to those changes, then I believe the results will really, really show up a lot when 2022 begins, especially abundance. So financially, I don't know what your situation is currently, but things are going to get better and they're just going to be peaking in 2022. Okay, that's my prediction right now for your 2022. So it's going to be a good year for you. That is what I intuitively sense for your next year as well. I've already done a video which is like, what do the next half of the year bring for you, next 6 months. Make sure you know, take a look at that. I'll link it down below in the description box. So overall, these are your letters. Let me know what you find. Let me know if you find your initials. I'm going to give you a couple of more, because I gave the last pile or a huge lot. So I don't want to be, partial to them. I just want to give everybody equal amount. So yeah. So now let me know if you find anything significant here. But overall, this is what your reading is for the month of June. Keep doing what you're doing once you make, those choices. Because once you stick to the new path, I believe it'll bring you abundance. So that's it from me when it comes to your month of June. I wish you the very, very, very best. And all my best wishes are with you. I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Hello, my beautiful and magical pile threes. How are you? And I am bringing forth to you your energies of June. How was your month of May? How is your month of May going? Do you have any plans for your June? Any resolutions that you've made? Let me know. Anyway, from your tarot cards, I'll just lay them all out and we'll just take a look at your reading. All right. First of all, let me tell you this. If you've been worrying about a certain situation in your life, there is nothing for you to worry, because honestly, nothing is going to be coming out of that situation, okay? Because so just don't worry. I want you guys to look at your June as a month full of possibilities, okay? Because the very first card that was on the pile was wide open. So this month, for the month of June, I do believe it will be a month, whatever you make of it, it'll be that. So this is like an ideal month when it comes to manifestations, all right? But you'll also see a lot of opportunities are now going to be presenting itself. Opportunities of change, opportunities for new beginnings. But what I see you guys doing is, you are basically this month really in the mode of observation. Like, you don't really want to make too many changes. You just want to plan them first. So I do see you guys really, opening your diary, opening your journal, looking at your plans and seeing how much you've accomplished so far and how much is meant to be there. Again, you'll also be making a lot of changes to the things that you've already started working on. For example, if you're working on a project and you feel like you're not making the progress that you are, or if you feel like certain things are working better than others. So I feel like you guys are course correcting this month, okay? Either way, the energy is slow, the energy is steady, but it is one of forward movement. Again, the emphasis this month is on learning. So there is a possibility you may, guys, start up a new course, you may start reading a new book or getting information on something that you want to work towards. This can just be something like you want to buy a new house, you're looking into information, you want to start a new business, you're doing the research. So basically this month is very research oriented. But again, with the new beginning card showing up, this can actually be a research for something new, something you want to do in your future, all right? But of course, for a couple of you, this could also be the start of a new project, start of new employment, starting a new job, starting a new process is also very much likely. Again, exercise routine, very much a possibility. But what is also happening here, especially when it comes to your romantic life, is probably you are noticing somebody or somebody is noticing you, okay? But this stage is only about observation, like, okay, I like this person. Is this person right for me? Should I go for this person? But either way, I feel like if this is a new person whose energy is coming in, the attraction is very much mutual, okay? Because you also have the Two of Cups showing in. But either way, emotionally, you guys are feeling very, very good. In fact, there is a good connection that is going on. So even if this is an initial attraction, it's a good attraction. New friendships, it's a good month for that. So especially new beginnings can also be in the form of new friendships. New beginnings can also be in the form of new partnerships. Maybe you will realize that there is this one specific colleague that you really work well with and you decide to work together. Again, moving into business with your spouse or a partner or a family member, working together with this person is also very much on the cards. Financially as well, this is going to be a good month, all right? But I don't really see this as being an excessively good month, but money is good. You have good amount of money to be spending out here. But let me tell you, this month you will have a tendency to spend more than what you have, okay? Because you've been suggested moderation. Now, moderation in spending is advised, moderation in eating, moderation in anything, all right? Moderation in shopping, make sure you're paying attention to that, especially if you're prone to eating some kind of food, especially sugar or something that is slightly unhealthy. Make sure you're curbing that because you don't want your health to suffer as a result of this, okay? Just pay attention to that. One more thing that is showing up for you is justice. So I do believe things will be very fair for you. But again, this can also be you weighing the pros and cons of a situation. Like I said, you're very much in the observation mode. You are on the verge of taking some decisions, okay? But you're not really sure about them, and which is why you're guessing and second guessing yourself. But if you have any legal issues that are pending for you, I do really see those going in your favor. But again, this month, I see you guys signing certain documents, taking a look at certain documents, bank related documents, financial documents, new job opportunity related documents, but some documentation, contract signing is very much on the cards. Like I said, you know, partnership businesses, especially that is on the cards. Then again, you could be signing documents relating to that, documents relating to a new home, a new vehicle, a new business, very much on the cards. One thing that you need to be careful about this month is confrontation, because there is a possibility of you entering into an argument with people, okay? This can be because people are opposing you, people are opposing your ideas, or they do not agree with the way you work, or they do not agree with certain plans that you have for yourself. But please make sure that this doesn't really get into a full kind of battle, especially because of Mercury really being tricky this month. Please ensure you're being very careful about what you say. And if you feel like you are entering into a situation where confrontation is very likely, please ensure you are really taking the moderate approach, because saying something and regretting it is also very much a possibility for you. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to be giving you one card from this, or maybe multiple cards, I don't know. Let us look into it. See, this is why I usually don't shuffle on camera, because I am kind of clumsy. I'll take this. Dream. Okay, basically you're being asked to follow your dreams and your yearnings. So again, you know, especially with the new beginnings card, if you feel like you want to start something towards your dream, like if you have a passion project, if you want to learn something, if there is a dream that you have, then make sure you're following up with it, okay? In certain cases, even looking up details about it, doing some research as to what you can do to actually fulfill your dream much earlier, then maybe that is something you should do. But again, pay attention to your dreams. That is also something I'm going to be telling you. Journey, again, there is a possibility of travel for you. Half the treasure is the journey on the path to finding it. So even if you feel like your guys are slowing down a bit, even if you feel like reaching a place or reaching a goal is taking time, learn to enjoy the journey, because the learning process, the journey in itself is actually very, very fulfilling, okay? So just enjoy the process is also something that is showing up for you. And safety, don't be too proud to go back to the shore. Again, you know, you guys are already playing it safe. So if you feel like, is this the right thing to do? Is this not the right thing to do? It is right if it is right for you, okay? Because if you guys are playing it safe, it's okay. Don't be too proud to go back to the shore, all right? So take your time, follow your process. Even if you feel like it's delaying things a little bit, it's okay. And honestly, in life, it is important to slow down. I have actually missed 2 days of posting. Like, I'm usually posting like alternate days, but I've been taking 2 days off because I just want to slow down myself and just enjoy the journey, all right? Please do that. If you feel like you want to give yourself time, if you want to just not do anything, please follow that, yeah? Because again, this month, the message in itself is moderation. Do things one at a time. Do things at your own pace. I am loving the energy of your month, yeah? So I'll just give you your numbers. You have 16. You have 21. These are important dates for the month. And again, angel numbers as well, 33. Again, pay close attention to your communication patterns. Very, very important. Again, pay attention to your dreams. Pay attention to what you're listening to on the radio. Because this month is actually going to be sort of a catalyst for you. Catalyst for a lot of changes from July onwards. Yeah. So enjoy the journey. Don't really worry about anything. Anything that is meant for you will always come to you. Always remember that. The timing may be different, but nobody can actually deny that is what I'm going to tell you. Your letters, you have L, you have I, you have N. What is missing is O. You have the lion then. Oh, you have a blank tile here. And again, if you find your initials, let me know. If you find your full names, please let me know. Yeah, then you have S, sail. Okay, so this is sail. So take your own time, you know, just take your own time. Sailing, if that is something that you do, moving on water, journey over water, if that is something that is, you know, something you can do where you live, then, you know, maybe that is something you'll do. Jen. So is there somebody named Jen as my subscriber? Let me know. And you. Okay, so overall, those are your letters. And if you find your name, if you find your initials, let me know. All right, and overall, this is your reading. Please pay attention to your communication pattern. Possibility of a confrontation is there. Avoid that. Go and follow your dreams at your own pace is what I'm gonna leave you with. You have the world wide open to you. What do you want to do with yourself is the question. Yeah. So I wish you the very, very best for the month of June, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.